Now on BBC One, we join Barry Norman for tonight's edition of Omnibus.
Begin with a film that sets out to illustrate and compare the different styles of five photographers. And what each of them was asked to photograph for us can hardly be described as still life, since her name is Jilly Johnson, and she's a very animated and lively young model. The photographers under review are Patrick, Earl of Lichfield, Jane Bown of The Observer, Beverley Goodway, who took one of those well-known page three portraits, but insisted stoutly that he was really interested in the lady's face, Jo Spence, a feminist who used Miss Johnson to make a personal comment about the advertising industry and its exploitation of women, and Bob Carlos Clarke, who can perhaps best be described as a surrealist. The film was made by Bernard Clarke, and I'd better warn you now that those who are offended by the sight of the unclothed female body can look forward to being duly offended.
Morning. Straight through.
Yeah, straight through.
Hey, thanks, Patrick.
Open your mouth a tiny touch. That's good. Just too much. It's too much. Lift your chin up and look a bit snooty. That's good. Slightly aggressive. That's lovely. Keep the nose to me at all times.
I've done a very all-round lighting with a lot of softness. And I'm really going for the eyes and mouth and face straight on so that it's just, you know... If being blonde and with that kind of skin, you can afford to do a very high-key look to it, which... In this case, I think will be a nice contrast to the way I normally have seen pictures of it.
Marvellous. Just keep that. And again, I don't want to move it to the thing. I'm doing the... No, nothing wrong with film.
That's fine. What's wrong?
I didn't... Can you do that?
Yes.
Don't.
I'm really into gurning, actually.
Are you?
Yeah.
let's have one.
All right.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, come on, because we're going to use this as a picture. Top model looks like that. Stick it on a composite and go and try and work in Timbuktu. Okay,
now,
straight into the camera.
But seriously.
Yeah.
You're cracking up.
It's probably quite good for a face, actually, isn't it? That's good. Because they say do exercises. That's lovely. Still, keep it. Don't move. There. She naturally, I think, because she's photographed so often that way, and I said turn that way and giving the shoulders sideways, she did the thing that a lot of people do, which is to lift their shoulders up, which is a kind of page three thing, if you see what I mean. Whereas, in fact, if you're doing a beauty shot and you want neck, you definitely don't want shoulders up that high.
Pretty cool.
And it's exactly that sort of look. Here we go. That's it. Oh, I wasn't in focus.
Just
do it again. Do it again. Look at me. That's nice. That's lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Good. It's nice because it's a change from what, you know, where we normally see her. She proves the adage that we've got a good model. We have to give her very little instruction. I mean, so long as she knows what you want before and she reacts to the clothes.
One more. What does it say about your style of photography?
Well, it says that I like people moving. It says I like clean white backgrounds. I like one splodge of colour and contrast in this way, so that it's graphic. And whichever shot I use, I'm not sure which one I will use, will probably be more indicative of what my photography is about than I can tell you now.
goodness. I'm so sorry to keep you waiting.
All right, I was early.
I was brushing to put the makeup on. I haven't done my hair yet, so I don't always look like this. I was going to be all nice and tidy. So
I don't want you tidy, do you?
I look like Wurzel Gummidge
at the
moment.
You look lovely as you are.
Right, what are we doing?
Well, I thought I might put you down there. I don't know. I'm a bit worried by all the makeup.
So I'm just going to rub it on.
I mean, I'm just not used to working with models, and I mean, I like to sort of... I like a real picture, and I feel like it's... I mean, I don't like disguises, put it that way.
I am surprised. I'm wondering why she wants me to take it on. I've just spent 10 minutes putting it on.
I'm used to very natural faces. I mean, however they are, you know, warts and all, I mean, that's how I usually... Those are the people who present to me.
Usually when they want natural pictures, the makeup is so carefully done it takes longer than an ordinary makeup session.
I'd feel more at home without all the makeup, I think.
Oh dear, I so carefully camouflaged that nasty one there. That's going to be on a show.
I'm very watchful when I take a face, and that's something I'd have to penetrate, that makeup. There she is. Yes. You're happy like that. Yes. That's smashing.
Yes.
What I'm going to do, I'm going to sit you down there, I think.
About my camouflage.
To me, you look so you've got plenty on, so there we are. But I'm going to start moving further. I mean, I just wonder if you can squat down there, and it's cold for your body. Is it? I don't know. I may be wrong, you see.
Right.
Can you squat?
Just here.
I mean, lean. I just want to see what the light's like. Oh, it's very beautiful. Very beautiful. It's dead easy when the light's good. You see, it's marvellous. Getting a bit. There we are. No, that's it. It's smashing. I'm going to get your. Is it a puma?
Pardon?
You've got a. There you are. The light in your eyes. That's. There we are. There we are. That's a smasher. Don't move. No, you see, you're used to it. I mean, I love it. I just.
Do you want me to get the cheetah?
Oh, would it be fun? He's a nice prop.
He's lovely.
And you're dressed properly. Ah. I almost don't need that. That's it. And as you were. No, you... There. And then eyes. Eyes at me. That's it. I've got two amazing pairs of eyes. It's brighter than I think. I'm using the daylight. And... I mean, I always look for one thing only. That's a marvellous light in the eyes, because I like to see eyes. And I like light in them. When she turns this way, she's moving. I was very simple. I just like her looking straight into the daylight. And when she looks this way, she's losing it.
It's better anyway, isn't it?
Yeah. Looking into light. It was a very beautiful light this morning.
Now, I noticed that the whole session took 18 minutes. Is that fairly standard?
I like to think I have half an hour, but I'm usually quicker than that, yes. 20 minutes is fine.
Now, given that some of the other photographers take all day, why is that? Why are you so quick?
Training. I mean, I work for paper, and usually we're doing people who are in a hurry, and I have to be quick. Years of practice.
Quite nostalgic. Yes. It's been here for about 2 years.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, it's lovely around here, though, isn't it?
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
That was quick, wasn't it?
What a charming lady. I thought she was very pleasant, very nice. Straight to the point.
18 minutes it took her.
It's amazing. Fantastic. I wish every session was like that.
Nice to see you.
And you?
Oh, you're looking nice today.
Hey, you're
from I like the colour. Come on in.
Straight through.
Straight through. Have a cup of coffee. That is what
Oh, is this the bath?
I'm going to put you in. I think without water, just sort of crouching in it. Ignore the vents, they won't show. One of those nice crouching shirts. Is that your set?
Wet
pan?
Oh, greaseback, marvellous.
It's getting warmer in here. It was a bit cold to start with.
Could be a polyfiller job today, or even a paper bag job.
I doubt it.
What I'm trying to do is like Jilly from the side, probably more so than I do in most shots, to give the picture strength by using shadow down one side. Are you ready now? Smells nice, if nothing else. Is it warm enough?
Yes.
Do you want to just try crouching in there a moment
okay,
and see what...
OK, I thought you were going to do a side view.
Oh, it works, just like that. It's absolutely super. Let's get this bowl out of the picture for me.
I wish I might need something just to be raised a little.
Really?
Yeah, what do you think?
Right at the back there? Or
just to put my feet on.
Yeah. What do you want, an E to K or an A to D?
Oh, an A to D would be perfectly.
Oh, it's yellow pages.
I have a GP on your telephone directories you used for.
That's nice. They're That's lovely. Up. No, you're all right. Looks marvellous. Looks super. No. I like the thought of you holding that over your right boob somehow, with just hooking your elbow around the left one. Would that... No, but it's so nice. Don't lose that shape. It's ever so nice. There. Lovely. And that hand in a bit there. Lovely. Yes. I've lost the focus. That's it. There. Super. There. Yes. There. Super. Lovely. And again. There. Yes. Very nice. Now, if you can lean back... Jill is taken over totally.
Yes.
And the hip bath is incidental now. It just sets the scene for the picture. I think it was the right idea, and I think the right things are happening in it.
Do you come here with a view as to what the photograph's going to be like, or do you just come here completely blank and then...
Usually completely blank, yes, with usually no face or hair or anything prepared for anything.
A sort of
it could be anything, yeah.
A blank sheet and...
Yes, a canvas, yes.
I'm purely finding a pleasing shape that makes Jilly look very attractive, which will condense into... a small space and have tremendous impact.
Do you see it as being creative?
I think it's mildly creative. A quick Polaroid before you get too wet. Yeah. Can you keep the right hand in? That's it. Yes.
You've just splashed it all in my face.
Hang on. It's not right. You're too hard. That's super. That's very nice. Yes, absolutely perfect. Yes. Now this is all getting too dark, actually. What could you do with a white towel?
It doesn't seem much, does it? It is quite an effort. While we're working, he's got things buzzing around in his mind, I think, exposures, etc., etc., and I've got, you know, I'm thinking about, am I sucking my tummy in enough?
Yeah.
Is it at all a sexual thing?
Oh, definitely not. No, hardly.
But that's the way it will be perceived.
It will be, yes. People, I mean, you see people walking around with the sun going, oh, catch, you know, cop an eye full of this sin, eh? What? Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. It's not like that at all.
Doesn't that bother you at all?
No. It's my job.
Do you intend to be titillating?
Not entirely, no. I don't think one does at all, in a way. One is looking for an attractive picture. One is really, as I said before, photographing the girl's face. And to me, it's almost incidental that she happens to be topless. That is not the important thing in the picture. It's the look in her eyes that comes through to the camera that makes the picture strong.
De-glamorise you or anything. I'm just going to show literally the environment that you're in.
How it is?
Yeah, right. That's it.
So, okay, we'll clear around the kitchen. Sink then.
Yes, okay. Close the door.
come inside. There's a story here that will not be denied. The tales of fools gold turn the hearts cold of many men.
Grab the whatever it is. Morning fresh. Listen, if you were going to be photographed for your mother.
Yes.
What would you do for the camera?
My mother?
Mm.
I think this is a nice, happy, smiling okay. picture.
What, not quite so zany?
Yes, I think just a very normal picture.
Mm. Okay. I think most women's magazines obscure the fact that most of us are going to spend a lot of our life at the kitchen sink. And they tend to concentrate on the face and the body with no environment at all. And sell us the idea of being as beautiful as possible, to be as lovable as possible, so that we can end up at the kitchen sink.
So in a sense, this is a political picture that you're doing?
With a little P.
Sorry.
But seriously, folks. Okay, relax, because I'm going to do it in black and white now.
Okay.
That's colour.
And nobody's ever taken pictures of me like this.
Yeah, now that looks marvellous as soon as you start posing. Okay.
You know, Joe, it's really out to destroy me. Actually, this is quite fun, isn't it, doing the opposite?
I know. I'm going to come back to colour again now,
okay.
Actually. I forgot to do that, the cigarette.
Right. No, it's not every day when somebody wants me with a penny on with a bag hanging out of my mouth doing the washing up.
Is there a kind of tension?
Yes, I do feel very strange because in years and years, this is the first time I feel slightly nervous. I'm so used to sort of having my working clothes on, which is sort of virtually nil, and having lights and around me and having to be extrovert and perform. I'm so used to performing, and suddenly I'm being told to be natural and wash up and not throw it in the dishwasher, and do you know what I mean? And it seems very strange. I mean, all I need now is my rollers, dear, and my hairnet, and I mean, I'm here to order, don't I?
The point, Jilly, is you don't, though. I'm sure that you don't need any of those things. Yes, it's interesting, actually, because this is not modelling, this is acting, in my opinion. Mm. Look a bit more sluttish. Inverted commas, sluttish. No, you're overdoing it, Jenny.
Right,
naturalistically sluttish. Don't narrow your eyes so much. In fact, try and look vacuous. Still life now. Still life with a question mark. Let's see what that looks like. Oh, for an assistant.
Well, I find it really difficult to comment on this. I know it's supposed to be symbolic, etc., but it doesn't have much connection or much meaning for me. You know, I don't really see why we've got a pair of plastic boots with 65p. Mind you, I suppose I could use them. I just don't see the connection, really.
Bye.
All right.
Thanks.
Bye.
It's not a critique of women's breasts at all. It's just saying that within advertising, they have become a commodity.
Please, she's gone. Are you pleased she's gone now?
Well, it's just not my thing.
All I'm trying to do is get some idea of the balance of the lights. That's what this is about.
And that's the Polaroid there, is it?
And it'll probably be blank, because the first 10 normally are.
I have to balance all of them. Put with my bow and arrow poised.
Hail Caesar, and here's your...
Let me just get on.
Let me just get on first of all.
Okay. Have you tied up those tassels on the other side, yeah?
Keep your finger up to that, almost like over that.
Right. Yeah.
Okay, on your toes.
My wings.
Don't worry about your wings. Just behave yourself now. That's it. Good.
Oh, sorry. I've got cramp in my foot.
Is this going to work, this camera?
Sorry.
That's lovely. Oh. I love that man. That
if
man.
It wasn't for the BBC here, I mean, Bob and I would have killed each other by now.
This is not.
You stupid Paul, why are you doing a picture like that? Call yourself a model, call yourself a photographer.
Andrew. Stick another Polaroid on, would you? It's still sticking, you know. This is too. That's it.
I wasn't on the turf.
It doesn't matter. But I'm not a great fan of flash. I'd really rather be able to use either tungsten or natural light.
So what you basically use is one huge light to give
yeah,
you...
Yeah, yeah. It's probably to cover up... I mean, basically, I like to keep it very simple. If you could make a little squeak when you're in the right position.
I'll just say now.
Oh.
I'm losing the cover.
Hang on a second, just relax. Take a slow, that's it. Good. Okay, well, I'm really sorry about this.
Just in the position
first. Just
pray
to God this works now.
Are you ready? Go.
That was great. It's wonderful when you start to fall. If you start to fall,
if
keep
you could
falling.
Do the trampoline, I can bounce back again.
Great.
Now.
Oh, that was lovely. I'm sorry.
Oh, I have right. my.
Lovely. Good. Nice. Lovely. Very nice.
Now.
I did it. I can't. I mean, it's the result that counts. It hasn't exactly been a picnic.
What is it they say when there's a very fine borderline between genius and... What's the other one?
Madness.
Well, yes. No, I'm not being rude, because he is genius. He's slightly eccentric, slightly weird, and it all goes together, and he produces something quite, well, I think, unique.
I'm going to get a week to finish this in, and I'll spend about 3 days working in the darkroom of that. 3 or 4 days working in the darkroom. And then the rest will be working, doing the airbrushing and things. So what I'll probably do is perhaps print a bird in somewhere in the sky, probably on the left over there, and then print a landscape beneath her. And maybe I'll put her up on a column, lift her up and put her on a stone column, and then put a landscape of mountains and water, or perhaps a city underneath. There's a negative of a girl on the backdrop. That's the first shot. And then there's negatives of the mountains here, which are two negatives, in fact. It's two and that's three. And then there's a negative of the city at the bottom here, which is the fourth negative. And you start off by printing the girl in the sky, and then the number two and three are burned in afterwards. They're, you know, it's a complicated process. I mean, it sounds more complicated than it actually is to do. But you've got to keep areas clear as you print, and then substitute the second, third, and fourth images in the blank areas.
So
here it hasn't worked very well. I did about 25 or 30 prints to get it right.
Do you see it as a work of art?
I don't really know. I don't have any idea. Sometimes I do, depending on my frame of mind. Sometimes I think they're quite good, and sometimes I think they're very banal. And it's interesting that everybody's attitude to them is different. Some people think they're the greatest pictures they've ever seen, and some people just hate them.
I don't think there's an out-and-out winner. I think I like that one in the end. But I always do like the picture that sort of looks straight at me, which there she is. I thought when I took them there was one that jumped out, and when I looked at the context it didn't.
It's got tremendous strength to it, and Jilly's tan has worked very well. And I think she looks terribly sort of wholesome and attractive. And I think the black and white, within the context I took it, has also got the strength. It's quite a strong picture. But generally speaking, I think we've got the picture we were looking for.
I think they demonstrate what I wanted to demonstrate, which is, okay, it's about style, but it's also about continuous choices. That's what's going on all the time, which is why I thought it was important to show all this lot.
The ones you rejected.
This is everything I took. What I was trying to do here was to show something that we usually don't see, which is another use for documentary photographs, which is not on public view. And these are actually the type of images that are used in drug magazines aimed at doctors.
Are you pleased with that one?
I'm pleased with it as an idea. Technically, it's a lousy photograph, but I was working with very small equipment.
I don't really know at the moment. My own photographs tend to excite me for a short time, and then if I stuck that up on my wall, I'm not sure how long I'd go on looking at it. It's all right. I mean, it's a competent job, and I'm quite happy with it. I think it does have something, and she was working with me and me with her, and it gelled.
Well, I wonder which of those pictures you liked best. Jilly Johnson's own favourite was the portrait by Bob Carlos Clarke, depicting her as a sort of giant Eros about to dispatch an arrow into the flinty heart of some city stockbroker. Miss Johnson clearly has expensive tastes, because if you wish to buy that picture, it would cost you £3,500.